Today, we're going to master how to use essential lab safety equipment to ensure you're always safe and prepared. Before anything else, make sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to stay updated on new safety videos. Now, let's talk about safety shower and eyewash stations, essential for immediate response to spills or splashes. These stations should be no more than a few seconds away, ideally within 10 seconds of any hazard area, ensuring rapid access. For eyewash stations, activate the flow and lean into the stream. Hold your eyes open and roll them in all directions. This ensures the water reaches and flushes all parts of your eyes. For full body exposure, step into the safety shower and activate it, usually done by pulling a lever. Flush affected areas for at least 15 minutes to ensure all contaminants are washed away. Remove any clothing that may have been contaminated as quickly as possible. Next up, fire extinguishers. These safety equipment are strategically placed throughout the lab, often near exits, in hallways, and close to high-risk areas for quick access. Operating a fire extinguisher is easy if you remember the acronym PASS. Pull the pin to unlock the operating lever. Aim the nozzle at the base of the fire. Squeeze the lever gently to release the extinguishing agent. Sweep the nozzle from side to side, covering the area of the fire until it's completely extinguished. Now, let's discuss fire blankets. Fire blankets are great for smothering flames, especially if a person's clothing catches fire. Don't try to run or beat the flames. Instead, wrap the blanket tightly around the person or the flame source to cut off oxygen and extinguish the fire. Hold it by the corners and shield your hands. If it's a person on fire, ask them to stop, drop, and roll. Then, drape the blanket over them. Ensure the blanket covers the fire entirely and leave it in place until the fire is suffocated. Avoid pulling away the blanket too quickly as it may reignite the flames. Remember, fire blankets are for one-time use. Once you've used it to extinguish a fire, it should be replaced. A fume hood is used whenever you work with chemicals that emit hazardous vapors or dust. It's especially crucial for handling acids, solvents, and other volatile organic compounds. To use a chemical fume hood effectively, first ensure that it's operating properly, check the airflow, and make sure the exhaust system is not obstructed. Once that's done, open the sash window only as far as necessary to work comfortably. Place all materials at least 6 inches inside the hood to prevent any vapors from escaping into the lab. Keep the sash between you and the chemicals at all times to serve as a protective barrier in case of splashes or reactions. Finally, let's talk about the first aid kit. No lab is safe without a well-stocked first aid kit. This usually includes bandages for cuts and abrasions, gauze pads for larger wounds, adhesive tape, scissors, tweezers, gloves to maintain hygiene, antiseptic wipes to clean wounds, and burn cream. Familiarize yourself with your first aid kit's contents and the basic first aid procedures. Always check and restock your first aid kit regularly, especially after it has been used. This ensures you are always prepared for any minor medical situation that might arise in the lab. You'll usually find first aid kits easily accessible in common areas of the lab, near workstations, or in hallways. And that's a wrap on our mastery of the essential lab safety equipment. Remember to always know where your safety equipment is located and understand the correct usage of each piece of safety equipment. Staying prepared means staying safe. Hit the like button if you found this video helpful, and we'll see you in the next video.